Hello, my name is Scott for SB Gaming, and welcome back to Transport Fever, Hard Mode Truck Fever Edition. And in the last episode, we got some passenger services up and running in between, of course, Salinas and Buffalo. And of course, we have our first city-to-city transportation of cargo. We're delivering four food over to the Buffalo branch, which I'm going to name... we're going to call this Buffalo Freight. And so, yeah. It has been slow getting going, but that is because we are limited in the funds that we have available to us. Because reasons. Notably, we are not taking any loans in order to get the... whatever one it is. Penny Pincher. In hard mode. Don't take any additional loan until the year 2000 in hard mode. We are also doing the... Truck Fever. Earn 50 million not using any train. So yeah, I bet that. You can use ships. You can use planes. You just cannot use trains. So yeah, I bet that. We could think about using train or ships. We have Denton here, we have Athens here, we have Wichita Falls there, and that's pretty much it. Three towns, Tampa here. Well, we can make a central hub here, Wichita, Denton, and Tampa. Nah. What's a little bit disappointing, although we could bring people down to the coast... This is also a hard hilly map, so yeah, about that. Although, with that said, yeah, the coast is very flat. Lots of places to build on the coast. So yeah. Although right here, it's a little bit tight. Anyway, we have $258 in our bank. Let's let things tick, and... Oh, we got 22 units sitting here, so we might as well buy a couple more road vehicles, and this is going to be 1F, and these are both going to go to Salinas Freight. This truck has almost made it. This truck has one unit of fuel. Probably what I'm going to want to do is just have this... load of available. And very conveniently, an additional unit of fuel. Yeah, about that. So, what we are, of course, going to want to do then is ramp up the number of trucks on the fuel line. 3 Buffalo oil. How are we doing? We have a 56 second frequency. 25 second frequency, 91 and 82,000 profit. These are losing us money, but that's just to be expected. It's peanuts relative, so about that. We're gonna buy some more. Oh no, not those. And just to make sure I didn't put in a... yeah, I didn't. Okay, good. We are going to buy some horse wagons and buffalo oil. And thankfully, they end up going directly into the truck station. I don't have to deal with any issues there. And... yeah, that's on a full load any. Salinas food. And we have 14 food sitting here. Oh. And we got four people wanting to travel up to Buffalo. That is nice. All right, about that. Do we have anyone sitting here? Nope. All right, about that. Well, what we are going to do is we are going to buy another horse carriage and we are going to send it to the 1P line. And this is going to Salinas Central. Yep. Perfect. And what I might as well do is bump up the number of vehicles on the Salinas local route. I'm not seeing any passengers though. Same thing over here. These are going to lose us a little bit of money to start, but hopefully 3-minute service. Yeah, that's the thing. Frequency is very low, so people are less likely to want to travel. $166,000 in the bank. How are we doing? We're losing $142,000. Of course, we have a bunch of new vehicles on the road. $150,000 a year, so not that bad. 20 units of food sitting here. And we have 5 units of food sitting here, so we are going to buy another horse wagon, set it to the 1F, and that is going over in that direction. Nice. We are going to buy another road vehicle, horse wagon, and 1F. And we have 7 people that want to travel to Buffalo, so we're going to throw on another carriage to the 1P line. Actually, we're going to put a second one on. This will help to improve the frequency, which of course will help to improve the willingness to travel. And we got 5 people sitting here. Nice. Let's buy a road vehicle and build to the 1P line. Nice. Come on in. Units sitting here. We are going to buy a couple road vehicles, 1F, and road vehicle 1 has reached its lifetime and should be replaced. Yeah, about that. I have a list of dates when you should stop buying vehicles, just because reasons, because of the new set of vehicles that do come out eventually. I think it's 1875 that the next passenger vehicle comes out, and it's 1872 when the next freight vehicle comes out. We got one person sitting there. We got 2 people sitting there. We are going to buy 3 horse vehicles for the local route and 3 for the Buffalo local route. You're going to buy horse wagons for the Buffalo oil. We're down to 48-second frequency, 119,000, and a 25-second frequency, 147,000 a year. And our 1F line has made a profit. Nice. Actually, our 1P line hasn't made any money. It dropped off nice. 377. Okay, that's not that bad. And yeah, our road vehicles are reaching their lifespan. 12 people. We have... Alright, we're going to add 2 more horse carriages on the 1P line. And over here, we have 3 people. On the Buffalo RT1 line. Let's buy a bunch of horse carriages and Buffalo RT1. And Salinas. Oh, missed it. Come on, one more. Anytime now. Anytime now. There we go. And Selena's RT1. How are we doing for frequency? 92 seconds and 86 seconds. 4-minute frequency on that. 5-minute frequency on that. And we have 55 units sitting here. We are going to buy, if we can. Yeah, this is going to be the slow part of the series. Waiting for a little bit of money to roll in. 1F. And you are an RF Buffalo Oil. Okay. You are an RF Buffalo Oil. And yeah, I know my vehicles have reached their lifespan. But the money should be storming back anytime. 130K. Ooh, 50. What's going on here? Are we losing money? Going on here. Unless it's because of the aging vehicles, that could be it. Yeah, about that. If we take a look at this, finances. Over time, your vehicles age, and of course, they cost more to run. Actually, yeah. This was our best year here. Then as we've added. One thing I might want to consider. Wow. 149 potential, ship more food. Well, produce more food. Although, with that said, yeah, we got a lot sitting here. We have 191K in the bank. Let's buy some more horse wagons for the 1F route. And yeah, I may want to think about replacing the vehicles. Alright, well, Salinas food. We are going to set vehicle. Yes. And we're just going to have it 100%. Yes, I know. And now, new vehicles. Road vehicle 3 has reached its lifetime, should be replaced. Yep, I know. Don't need to be warned. What that should hopefully do, and actually, logo. Put our logo on the trucks. This should, yep, drop our running costs, allowing us to make more profit overall. All right about that. But yeah, our profits kind of dipped on this, of course, with that said. Yeah, we've been capping out on the number of amount of food, and all of a sudden we have an influx of food sitting here. 50 food. Wow. So all those trucks that were running half empty, that has kind of caught up to us. 18 people want to travel to Buffalo, so we might as well allow them to do that. And we got 13 people that want to travel to Salinas. We're going to buy one from here and Salinas. And that's going the right direction. And just to make sure, we're going to load if available. We're down to 3 minute frequency on each line. 132K, 93K. units of food sitting in there. We have 8 units of food sitting there. 14 of these are losing us money. Finances. We had one profitable year. Well, we've had 2 profitable years here. It is 1868. It'll be some time before we're out of debt. And we want to do vehicles. Yeah, we're spending a lot of our money on new vehicles. And we are going to run another horse carriage. 1P. And yeah, we have Horse Wagons stopping here. Basically, they should come in like this, stop here. They should either come in like this, stop here. Come in here, stop here. Or come in here, stop here, and go out that way. Yeah, about that. We're kind of treading water. We have 30k in the bank. And there is the beginning of a new year. Well, our freight line is starting to make some decent money. 47.1k. Buffalo oil, 80k. Salinas food has rebounded. We're up to 146k. Going up and down. It's just to be expected. But most likely that has to do with the fact that we are refreshing the vehicles. So their age is, of course, reduced. Because right now, this one is running a year old. This one is a year old. This one is a year old. That one's 9 months, so a lot of these looks like they have been refreshed. So we can turn auto replacement off. Yep. How are we doing for our oil vehicles? Only 5 years, so yeah. About that. So we're going to rebound our money back. It's not going to be much of a problem. We're kind of losing money on our local routes. Partially that's because, of course, we have the loop going. And we have 97 food sitting there. We have 3 food sitting here, or fuel. Yep, we're going to buy a couple more horse wagons and 1F, Salinas to Buffalo. No, that's carrying 4 fuel. That's carrying 4 fuel. That's nice. 4 fuel. And we are going to buy some more horse wagons for the oil line. Our Buffalo oil. And what I'd like to do is color code these. I think I used the teal for the freight and lime green for the passengers. We have those. Buffalo oil is going to be black. Salinas food is going to be yellow. Truck's kind of queuing up to wait. Come on, just get going. Lots of fuel here, or lots of crude. Come on, get going. Get going. Get going. Get going. Yeah, they're a little bit slow to get up this hill. 7 kilometers an hour. And it is 1870. We have 50k in the bank. A little bit disappointing, but that's just to be expected. We are playing on hard mode after all. And we're paying 30k interest on $1.2 million of loans. You are on Buffalo oil. I'm going to hold off doing any more updates just because we know that coming up in the near future, there will be either a freight vehicle or a passenger vehicle. I think it's freight vehicles first and then passenger vehicles after that. So yeah, about that. What I might just do, I'll set this to 150% just because I really don't want to be annoyed by this. and 150%. If we look back at our Salinas food, yep, replacing those vehicles pulled back some of the expenses. We got $40,000 of expenses, so it's not too bad. We spend a fair bit to refresh the vehicles though. And we got 13 people that want to head to Buffalo. And that where's our nearest buses? Right there. Alright, we are going to buy a couple horse carriages. And we're going to put it on the 1P line. Whoa, where are you guys going? No. No. Don't be doing that now. You were working so nicely. You're all coming over here. And we have a nice chunk of fuel sitting here. What I wanted to do is buy some more horse wagons and 1F. Yeah, Salinas. It's going this way, this way, and this way. We have 27 people that want to travel to Salinas. Three of them and 1P. No. Please don't. How are we doing for total profits? And the horse trolley car in 1871. So if we wanted to, we could go trolleys or trams. And we have the Baldwin class 56. Yeah, about this. Did we set up? Yeah, we set up a freight. So what I might want to do is add a new destination. We are going to put a, first of all, the next town to go to would probably be Wichita Falls or Denton. So I probably want to run my passenger here. We're going to go with a large tram. Right there. And we are going to connect this up. That might have been a little too much to spend. Yeah, we can spend a little bit cheaper. Let's just put that there. And now we are going to want to have some bus stops. Right there. Right there. I'm going to do another one there. Right there and there. We are going to go with a depot. By road vehicles. We're going to go with a couple horse carriages. New line. Go from here to here. Back over to here. And this is going to be bus Tampa RT1. And then we are going to buy a horse carriage. And the American horse cart. Yep. We're going to set this to new line from here over to here. And this is going to be lime green. And this is going to be 2- Buffalo to Tampa 2-P. And we're going to go full load any. We are going to go unlimited. And then we are going to buy a new horse carriage and set this to 2P Buffalo to Tampa. And you are the 2P line. Okay, good. And just to make sure, 2P, yep. You, where are you going? Destination home. All right. It'll take a little bit while for this to get going, ramping up. Let's just buy a couple more horse carriages for the Tampa line, just to bump up the frequency. Yep, these are sitting at 88 and 85 seconds apiece. You'll want to, of course, increase the frequency even more. And we have 82 units sitting here. We have only 3 units sitting here. We have 100,000 in the bank. What I would like to do is bump up the frequency of Buffalo Oil a little bit more. We're going to buy some of the American horse carts, Buffalo Oil, and they are all going into this one here. Yep. All right, so that's what I'm going to do next. We are going to upgrade the vehicles on our freight line. We'll say yes, 25%, 25% yes. Yeah, we'll just leave that there. And what I might just do is leave this to run off screen. We might as well also set vehicle, American horse cart, 25% yes. Those will start replacing with the new version of the freight vehicles. They'll be able to carry more. They'll be able to make a lot more once, of course, the whole line has been flipped out. And it's just a matter of keeping things going. We have barely any money in their bank. Of course, this upgrade process is going to eat up the profits that we are making, but it'll be good overall. Anyway, at this point in time, I'm going to take a break here, and we will continue off with more Transport Fever, Hard Mode, Truck Fever edition in the next episode. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for watching. My name is Scott for SB Gaming, and as always, have a good day.